Hi folks, this is Peach Mario with the last video of this short introduction series about the custom markup plugin, where I have a closer look how can we create a presentation like this one. Yeah? But I will show you a simpler presentation, because this one is still a little bit complex and has a lot of room for improvements. Yeah? So let's search a test presentation where we have a presentation in one tiddler, yeah, which is a little bit simpler. So we have some horizontal slides, and then we have the possibility to create vertical slides, and then there is some animation, yeah, and we will have a closer look how all of this looks like. Yeah. First of all, the plugin that is used is called Reveal.js, yeah, which is done by Sukima, which is a wrapper for the Reveal.js library. Yeah. So Reveal.js.com, and the markup for the plugin or for slides basically looks like this. Yeah. So you have to create a div with a class Reveal, then a div class Slides, and then you have the different sections which define one slide, and if the sections are nested, then you have automatically used vertical slides. Yeah? And yeah, that's basically the main structure. And with the custom markup plugin, we try to recreate this structure. Yeah? So the first definition here is the degree glyph. And then there is the presentation, so the start of the presentation, and the end string is end. Yeah? So we have presentation here, sorry, is the start of the presentation, and then here we have the end of the presentation. Yeah? So this covers all the different elements. Then there you can see there are some styles. In normal cases they are part of a style sheet, but here this is done for experimenting, so we can quickly change it. Then there are the slides. Yeah? So presentation is the presentation widget, and then the default angle brackets are slides. Yeah? And those slides with the angle brackets, they have an end marker with these two minus minus. Yeah? Then there is an animated angle brackets, which is called angle anime. And they also have an end marker, and they have a parameter auto animate. Yeah. Then there are some tick elements, and the tick elements, they only cover for one, or they look for one line break as an end string. Yeah. So that's why there is no end string definition. Yeah. Okay, so we see there is the presentation start, then there is tick big. And the big is here, yeah, so makes it a little bit bigger, and it says welcome to Reveal.js. Yeah. And this is the first slide. Then we click, then we are at the second slide. Yeah. Then we click again, we are at the third slide, and this is the angle marker, yeah, which is called a slide, and it has an end string. Yeah. The angle marker is a start and the end string, paragraph 1, paragraph 2. Yeah. Then we have vertical slides, so this is the first slide, and here is a tick, yeah, and the tick is a one line slide, vertical slide, yeah, as we can see here, and down and so on. So here we have nested slides, and then there start all the different animations. Yeah. So if I click and so on, yeah, then there is automatically animated. Yeah. And as you can see, yeah, there is still some complexity in it. Yeah. So that's why it's not really finished. Yeah. So there is a lot of room for improvements, but you already can see how it could look like. Yeah. The end result should be more readable and easy to use, yeah, which is not really like this. Yeah. What can be achieved is something that in the end is not usable, but looks funny. Yeah, for example, there are some definitions and the slide works. Yeah, and this is how it's called. Yeah, completely unusable, but this is for testing. Yeah, so this is for testing if the plugin itself can handle it. Yeah, users cannot handle this. Yeah, but it's a nice experiment that shows what could be achieved if you want to drive it into the extreme. Yeah, that's basically it for the standard presentation. In the next video, I will show a little bit of an overview about the table of content. Have fun.